thanks for taking the time. You open up team tennis last weekend, a couple of home matches, Weber State and CU, and your team right there with both those teams.
Yeah, I was super pleased. And, you know, off the court, we had a rough week with a lot of kids sick, five of the eight, and to come out and compete and not complain and want to compete, you know, they were just like, hey, we're good. We don't need to get that extra COVID test. No, just joking. But no, they did get. And so they really showed up, competed hard, gave themselves an opportunity to win, which is what you want as a coach. The bottom half of our lineup was rock star throughout the whole weekend. We had some new kids step in and play, so that was something we didn't get to see in the fall. And to have that experience and see how they respond to team tennis was huge. I mean, Isabella Flodine, she hasn't played a singles match pretty much in a year. She didn't touch a ball in the fall. She came in rock star in the singles both days, really competed well. Andrea Lee came out just swinging. Her movement was amazing. And Ariana Van Halen was like, man, she just like, I'm here to compete, and she just did her job. So to have, you know, she went undefeated for the week, 3-0, for a freshman to do that, you got to be super excited. But super pleased with our doubles coming out. Weber State's always got top doubles, dominated the doubles there, made some adjustments to the next day, and even played better doubles against Colorado. So when you see that as a coach, the progress they made from one match to the second match, and the energy and the fight. Was really impressed with Sydney Fitch, you know, splitting sets at number one singles, you know, and had to be converted the last day with two of the split sets. We win 4-3, you know, against a power five, and even with kind of a team that was a little bit beat up. So as a coach, that's what you want to see.
Yeah, for sure. How important is it to get that first doubles point? Because I know in both those occasions, here you are, okay, we're ahead 1-0 going into singles.
You know, we didn't use it as well to our advantage the first match. I think we kind of won it and then kind of like, okay. But we're used to winning it a lot. We focus a lot on doubles. But for us, it gives us that depth. And so we can pick up three matches typically against a really strong team. Sometimes we don't have the depth 1-6. I mean, in every position, we were basically outrated based on ranking-wise. And so for us to win, we've got to play good tennis and we got to be accountable. If you have an off day, you're just not even going to have a chance. And so I think that's why that doubles gives us a little bit of breathing room. I think we made an adjustment from the first to the second day of using that energy and carrying it over. I'm like, hey, let's kind of put it in their face of like, you just lost a doubles point to Air Force. And again, I think now we've been doing this for years that I think of six of the last 7 years we've won the doubles point against Colorado. So I think they know like, hey, they play great doubles, so they don't kind of panic. But anytime that you can play a good team and win the doubles point, it just puts you in a mode that you have an opportunity to win.
Yeah. On the road this week, you go to Creighton, North Dakota. What do you want to see from your team again against two very good teams?
You know, first thing is on the road trip, we're going to have a team bonding experience. You know, so again, with a young team, getting to have some experiences that make that difference so they can grow as a team, I think that's going to be really important, and we're going to use that time. We're going to get to compete at sea level. So, you know, in a couple weeks, we go down to Florida to play Navy. And so just competing at sea level gives you a little bit of opportunity to, like, what's the difference, the ball, how it's going to do, the effectiveness of your doubles and things like that, because it plays a little bit different. So that will be good to see. And again, we've got one girl still that's coming back in the lineup from last week. So that will be interesting to see, you know, where she competes and where she comes in and, you know, kind of the depth of the team. So those are things we're looking for.
Should be fun. You're in the swing now, as we like to say. Coach Gidley, thanks for the time. Good luck this weekend.
Go Blue.